fight is only after Gideon.
One love.
So when the man comes, there will be no, no doom.
One song.
Have pity on those whose chances grow ten. There ain't no hiding place from the Father of creation. Yeah, yeah.
Good morning, everybody. Happy Tuesday. I hope everybody had a great weekend and so much fun at prom. Today, we have four speeches. First up is 12th grader Kai Arnold, so please welcome him to the stage.
My name is Kai Avi Arnold. I'm a senior. I value my friends a great deal. I consider them one of my top priorities. But even among my friends, one stands out. A friend you all may know, a friend that's there for me day in and day out, a friend that always makes sure I make it home safe, and a friend that I love with all my heart. For those of you who know me, you may have realized by now, I'm talking about my truck, the Danger Ranger. The Danger Ranger first came to my family when my uncle died. Both of my brothers drove it for a short while, but never stuck around. Until sophomore year, when I got my chance to drive this marvel of engineering. As soon as I started hanging out with the Danger Ranger, there was an instant connection. It might not be the cleanest truck, but it does have a way of sparkling when the sun hits it just right. And even though the camper shell changes color every couple months, the same great truck still remains. I've learned a lot from my friend over the years. I've learned how helpful a 10-millimeter wrench can be and some duct tape. I've learned just how helpful an amp would be if it didn't keep overheating. But most of all, I've learned that the most important thing in life are memories. I've made so many memories with the Danger Ranger. Being on Spartan Day when the speaker system almost shook it apart. Riding around with the Y-side sticker on the front windshield that reminds me of my brother and my hometown. Or fixing every little part on it with my dad, which shows how much he cares about me. But I've also made so many memories with the truck itself. Whether it was just a quick trip to the store or just a nice errand, I always enjoy the chance to spend some time listening to music with my friend. Even though I'll be leaving soon, I'll still cherish all the little trips and hiccups along the way that burn themselves into my brain and bring me so much joy. So as I leave, I say goodbye to my friend, but probably not forever. I'll figure out a way to get to the mainland. So thank you.
Thank you, Kai. Next up is a speech from another 12th grader, Avery R. Doyne.
Good morning. Do you guys like cookies? Yes. Right? Okay, so I have some cookies here, and let me tell you, they taste pretty good, okay? But these cookies are not any normal, ordinary cookies. These are cookies made with insects, okay? They're made with cricket flour. Cricket flour is pretty much ground up crickets into a flour that can be used as a flour substitute or used with other flours. And these cookies are powerful. They contain 20 more grams of protein and way more healthy amino acids than normal cookies. They can help even prevent hunger across the world. Normal cricket flour is more expensive than normal flour, but that doesn't always have to be the case. Crickets can be grown in indoor buildings all year round, temperature controlled, with access to anyone in large urban areas and even rural areas too. Unlike wheat, which has to be grown in only rural areas with big land plots. Wheat takes 2,000 gallons of water to create 1 pound of wheat. And only 1 gallon of water to create 1 pound of crickets. So you have a much more sustainable and eco-friendly source of protein and food than wheat. And cricket flour contains 60% more protein than 1 pound of beef than in 1 pound of crickets. And next time you think about what to eat, think about trying crickets because you never know, you might like them. Thank you.
Thank you, Avery. Next up is another 12th grader, Sean Cortez. So please welcome him to the stage.
Good morning. My name is Sean, and I'm a senior. Undoubtedly, perseverance and commitment are something that we all admire in a person, whether it be in excellence in your academics, mastering a sport, or pursuing a more personal passion. The time and relentless effort put into something that can measure days, weeks, or even years is always impressive. For instance, consider last week when 3 students here were recognized for their achievements in their sport of rodeo. Imagine the journey that they've gone through, the effort that it takes throughout so many years of their life to compete on the national level for something, for anything really. Imagine being a little 4 or 5-year-old where they probably started and they first mounted a horse. imagine being that young and then falling off of one. I know that my 6-year-old brother would probably ball his eyes out and then quit. But instead, imagine that little 5 or 6-year-old getting up and deciding, you know what, I'm going to do that for 10 more years and decide to be the best in my state at it. Not the falling off part, but the actual sport. Well, that might seem a little absurd to you, a 6-year-old getting up and deciding to do something for 10 or 15 more years of their life, because I'm hyperbolizing something. Not the scale of that achievement, but the actual process and decision-making that comes into committing to something. It's not just a one-time decision to propel yourself into a lifelong pursuit. Really, what commitment takes is a continuous series of decisions to always push forward despite challenges and setbacks to your goal. And that decision-making process is difficult. And I know that not because I've always succeeded in everything I've done, but because of the shared human experience of trying something but faltering and failing, and occasionally even giving up on something that you might want to do. But the thing is, that's okay, because even if you fail in something and you really don't think you have a chance to be good at it ever again, there are so many other things in your life that you can do that can give you meaning. I think that perseverance is a two-sided coin. There's the ability to channel that energy into something, a task that you want to do, but there's also the ability to pivot and direct that energy into something else should you need to. And I think that's something that is often overlooked in this day and age. I think many people try to commit into something and they're unlucky and it just doesn't fall through, and it falls through. And so they can get stuck in it. Like, think of a long-term relationship that just doesn't work out, or you really want to get into a college, but they reject you. A lot of people just don't know what to do and they can get stuck. And they can get stuck, even through all that they've persevered through, to try and reach that goal. But what they forget is that all that perseverance that they put into something, even if it doesn't work, they're able to redirect that and put it into something new. They let their achievements that aren't super high limit themselves, and they think, I put so much time into this, how could I ever do X, Y, Z? But in reality, those achievements are proof that you can do anything else you want to, and just redirect that energy. And so, if there's something that you are really striving for, but in the end, you're unlucky and it doesn't work out, know that that energy you put in, you can always put into something else. Thank you.
Thank you, Sean. So next up, please welcome Dylan Stolle to the stage in 12th grade.
Good morning, my name is Dylan. And before I start my speech, I want you all to think about what you did this morning. Did you start your morning with something fun or something you truly believe was productive? Now I know a lot of you may be thinking that it's way too early and that you're still just trying to wake up. And for those of you thinking this, believe me, I would definitely rather be in bed than on the stage. But I'm not. So instead, I'm going to share with you guys the benefit of starting your day off the right way by doing something you enjoy. First off, it is known that when you start your morning with something you enjoy, stress-relieving endorphins are released that start your day on a positive note. If this isn't enough for you, it's also known that starting your day like this sets you up for a more productive and successful day. Think of professional athletes like Michael Jordan or Kelly Slater. You can even think of a celebrity like Oprah. Alike, these people credit some of their success and their happiness to their enjoyable morning routine. For instance, Jordan would often start his morning at 5 a.m. with either working out, running a few miles, or getting up shots in the gym. This enjoyable morning routine and amazing work ethic took Jordan from not making his high school basketball team to being debatably one of the best NBA players of all time. On the other hand, Oprah's morning routine is much different. Starting her day with meditation, yoga, or even just an enjoyable breakfast. While much different than Jordan's intense morning routine, her personal routine makes her happy, and that's all it needs to do. Now that you guys understand what I'm here to talk about, I want you to imagine a noise, one I hate very much, the iPhone alarm clock. You roll over in bed and check your phone. It's 6 in the morning as you push your head into your pillow, trying to ignore the obnoxious ring. For me, this is the battle every early morning before working out, surfing, or doing any early morning activity. While the first step out of bed is always hard, I've realized that the joy and energy I bring through the rest of my day makes it totally worth it. While I find this joy by waking up and doing something active, you all can find it just by incorporating something you enjoy in your morning routine. So whether you're an early riser or someone who hits the snooze button a few times, I encourage you to reflect on your morning routine. Are you setting yourself up for success? Are you doing things that you enjoy and are fun? Remember, every morning and every day is a chance to enjoy your life, have fun, and leave an impact on the world and those around you. Thank you.
Let's give another round of applause to all of our speeches. And next up, we have some really fun interactive thing coming up. So please welcome Ms. Shad to the stage and Mr. Levian.
Hey, good morning, everybody. So this morning, you know, a lot of times on stage, what you see in assembly is like this product, right? These speech students have been working on these speeches all semester in their class, and now this is like the final presentation. And on Thursday, what's today? Tuesday, yeah. On Thursday, the band is gonna perform in assembly to show you what they've been working on. But today, what we're actually doing is we're inviting you to be part of the process of something we're creating for chorus, which is, I had this idea, I guess, maybe inspired by Taylor Swift, but I've never been to a Taylor Swift concert. But I was like, what if in this one song, everybody has something that flashes in the audience? Like, I really wanted this audience participation element. And it turns out that's really expensive. I looked into buying wristbands, I looked into apps and all this stuff. And so instead of spending many hundreds of dollars on a 2-minute song, I emailed Mr. Levian saying, like, do you have any ideas? And I think he emailed back in an hour and said, I wrote something. And so what we're gonna ask for you to do today is, after Mr. Levian introduces what it is he created, is we need your help in the process of testing all of this. We did ask you to bring your phones today, so when prompted, we're gonna ask you to bring those out. We invite you to be part of this process, and then if it works, woo! And if not, Mr. Levian will talk to you a little bit about that. And then if you want to see what this looks like in real life with live singers and everything, please get your tickets to the concert, which is next week, Saturday, okay? So I'm gonna turn it over to Mr. Levian, who's gonna talk to you about what he did.
All right, so I'm gonna give a shameless plug for programming and technology and engineering classes, but a lot of people think, can you switch to the Roku input? So this is the big demo, this never goes right. So we're hoping that we'll at least learn something from it. But when Ms. Shad asked what we could potentially do, she talked about looking into different options. She talked about buying stuff, buying some hardware, maybe writing a mobile app. And so as an engineer or an inventor, my first thought is, how do we make this as cheaply and easily as possible and as easy for everybody in the audience? And so everybody in my engineering class knows the process is the most important part. And so we looked into a couple of those things. We kind of evaluated, well, if we make a mobile app, we have to get Apple to approve it. We have to get everybody to download it in advance. There's so many challenges with getting that going. It might be the best, but it's gonna be challenging and time consuming. We looked at creating our own hardware, but maybe we could make 5 or 10 of them with our budget. And you know, that's not quite as impactful either. So I was recalling something I learned in class maybe 20 years ago in college about the way the internet works, which my AP class will talk about. But usually it's a request response. You request a website, you get a response back, and the server and the client know nothing about each other. But there's a protocol called WebSockets where they make a connection and they stay open for bidirectional communication. And you can actually broadcast messages. So I thought that might be an interesting thing to explore. And turns out it works really well. We wrote some code, and I guess my previous comment, this is what the code looks like. And so a lot of people see this and say, oh man, I could never do that. But it's a process of trial and error, building up from smaller pieces into a bigger project, doing research and trying to understand like what has the best possibility of working, and trying stuff. So what you're gonna see today is really our second test. Our first test worked in programming class. We had 12 or 14 phones, and it worked great. I have absolutely no idea what's gonna happen when we try to have hundreds of phones connecting, and so this is really the first big demo. And I was telling our speech students too, is this is the most terrifying moment when you're presenting something, you have no idea if it's gonna work. It worked when you tried it at home, right? I see Kai smiling over there, he knows the feeling. And I was saying the speech, like I've presented in my previous life before coming a teacher, I've presented to companies like the NFL, Sprint, ESPN, you know, dressed in a suit, and you're going in and giving a $10 million pitch, potentially. We didn't get that one. But this is more nerve-wracking than that, honestly. So congratulations to everybody for getting up here and giving those speeches. And I'll stop talking now, but a short plug for the technology is it's not just about the words on the screen, it's about solving a problem. And so if this works, it'll be awesome. It works for theater. You guys have probably saw, what was the snail's name again?
Gary.
Gary the Snail was a cool technology solution. Maybe a little bit overkill, but super fun. You saw the kettle that boiled over. That was also a fun engineering project where, you know, the same process applies to solving problems and coming up with a cool solution. So we're gonna see if this works. Can everybody pull out your phones and scan that QR code? Okay, if you're watching an advisory, don't do this just yet. So you can see my log, that's everybody logging into my, this is running off of my computer right here. So we're getting a ton of people connected. It should tell you you're connected. That's awesome, we'll give it another 10 seconds. Wow, okay, so it's not crashing yet, so that's a good sign. We always wanna observe and see what happens. Maybe some stuff is going on, I don't know, but I think I'm gonna start it. So if you're not in yet, maybe too bad. So the goal of this, you all now have a WebSocket to my laptop, which is kind of terrifying, but this web server is running on my laptop. We're gonna play the song, and at a certain point in the song, I'm gonna click the button, and it should start an animation. So we'll do a quick test. I'm gonna push the red button up here and see what happens. Oh no. Oh, there we go. All right, I see some red. That's promising.
Show the camera so people in advisory can see too.
That's gotta be like 100 devices. That's pretty solid. Let's go to white. Okay, that was pretty quick. And let's go to black. All right, so that was pretty good. Let's see what happens here. I'm gonna hit play. We should get some music. Uh-oh, our music.
No, it's
coming. Okay. That was pretty good. What do you think, Ms. Shad? Did anybody's phone not react? We had a few. Did anybody's phone not react to the lights? Only a couple? All right, well, Seemed good. We'll check with people in advisory if anybody in advisory tried it. But now I'm going to go back and analyze the logs and see what happened, see how many people connected, and we will train up the crew for the performance.
All right. So.
That was so much fun. you guys should all come see that song. I think you'll be wowed. And now for some announcements. Who watched Mary Monarch this week? Was last weekend. Woohoo! It was so awesome. It was so awesome to see some of our own students also up there on stage. Also, if you could all put your phones away, that would be great. here's our lovely students up on that Mary Monarch stage, Julia and Jasmine. If you see them in the halls, say congrats because they did so amazing and they danced so beautifully. Look at that. Oh, awesome. And please welcome Sean from the math team.
So I'd like to bring up our math team to the stage, including Mr. Wilson, with all of our trophies. So here we have Byron Joyner, Dean Tapler, and Wenbin Lee, our seniors. And so this Saturday, right before prom from 8 to noon, we had our there he is, Kellen. We had our very last math meet on the island, and we won 109 points to, I think, 37. So we tripled the score of second place, which was Maui High. And it was the end of our season, right? And so these are the rankings for the individual scores throughout the season. Wenbin scored the most points. There's his first place trophy. Yeah. Kellen Janik scored the second most points. Here he and here's my third place trophy, scoring the third most points. And so overall, we had a great season. We sweeped every single of our, one of our, I think, five math meets. Basically looked like the 109 to 37 thing five times. So we had a great season. And on May 4th, the day after Heiaupu Aloha, I think, we're flying out to the Big Island to compete in the State Math Bowl. And if we win this year, this would be our ninth row in a year winning the state championship. So wish us luck then. We'll be practicing over the next month. And yeah. Anyone else want to say something? No? All right. Thank you, guys.
Congrats, you guys. That's amazing. Give another round of applause for them, because that's awesome. And college visits. Today is the 9th, so Utah Valley University is going to be here during D-Block at 10:30 a.m. All visits in the college counseling, unless otherwise notified. And also remember that there's the college fair on the 15th from 5 to 7 p.m. at King Ke Kaulike in their gym, and 70-plus colleges will be there, so that's a lot. And let's get up our spirit committee. It's senior night this week. So remember that you can choose two things to go to before we recognize our seniors. You can either go to the boys' varsity volleyball game versus Lanai at 7, or you can go to the band spring concert also at 7 here in the CAC. And there's going to be senior roll call, lay giving, the video, dodgeball tournament. And there will be no pregame activities or food.
There's also a costume contest for the dodgeball tournament, and there's a super good prize, so you guys should all participate and get a group. Forms will be in the office shortly.
Also, on Thursday, we'll have a video explaining some of the cheers we'll do for volleyball, and we'll also get it posted on the Instagram so you guys can practice before the game. Woo!
And on senior night, those wonderful posters.
We're also making posters this week on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, so make sure you come out to make a sign for your poster. For your seniors.
I just wanted to say, even if you do go to the band concert, make sure to come down to the gym afterwards, because that's when all the senior night stuff will happen.
Come out to honor your seniors, and there's also tryouts for side shows tomorrow, Wednesday, from 3:15, or at 3:15 in room 201, or on Thursday, also at 3:15, you can come either day, no experience necessary, and you'll perform on May 17th to 18th. If you have any questions, go talk to Mr. V. And also remember that there's the student art gallery is back again. So help raise funds for yourself as well as financial aid during the craft fair, and contact the art teachers in person or via email for more information. And here's the student marketplace. It's $125 for a 6-foot table, $100 for a shared 8-foot table. So you have 4-foot space for yourself, and yeah, that's a really cool opportunity. So contact Ms. Pelletier if you're interested. And please welcome Riley and Zoe to the stage.
Hi everyone. So next week, Tuesday and Thursday, the Sea Club is gonna be putting on a thrift sale. So you can drop off, so please donate clothes that are in good condition, and you can drop them off to room 214, which is Miss Gans in the upper school, or room 23, Miss Miller's in the middle school.
The shop will be in the upper level of the gym, and the proceeds will go to Maui Strong. So please come out and support. Thank you.
Thank you guys. And then also remember, there's a CSL opportunity. You can volunteer after school in the edible garden. Email Miss Ryden for details to sign up. And this weekend is a pop celebration this Friday before senior night. So remember, you can also go to this. And it's also at 7 p.m. So information and tickets, go to seaburyhall.org/arts. And also, next weekend is our Radio Rewind, a Pops Choral Concert! Woo! We have some really fun songs. We have stuff from the 80s, the 50s. You'll be surprised. But if you come, you can see them. Tickets are selling fast and are available on GivePulse. And TEDx is this weekend! So we have a great lineup of speakers. Come see your fellow students. Tickets are $8 for students, $12 for adults. We actually only have 37 tickets left. We sold 63 tickets, but that's amazing. So you guys should all get your tickets before they run out.
And we also, if you guys need CSL hours, there is a last minute CSL hour opportunity. So email Harmony if you want to come volunteer, you know, pass out some pamphlets, talk to some audience members. That's basically all you have to do. So, yeah.
If you want to help make goodie bags and staple brochures together as well, just email me. And yes, you guys should all come out. So have a great day. Thank you.